Hello, Monkston Primary School, and welcome to one of your Super Bowl challenges this week, which all of the school are able to enter. And this is the creative element of the activities. So we'll go through what you can do, and I'll give you some examples, and hopefully they'll inspire you to produce something that you can send in a picture of to your year group inbox. So first and foremost, let's quickly talk about the NFL and American football. Now, the version of the game that year three would have been playing this year, and hopefully year four next year will get an opportunity to play, isn't quite like this. It's not quite as physical. It's more like tag rugby, where you have flags down people's belts that you can pull off to make them intercept the ball. But in the real version of the game, because it's so physical, the players wear helmets to protect themselves. And they usually have a design representing the team that they play for on the side, and often the colours that represent that team on the helmet as well. Looks pretty cool. There are currently these teams in the National Football League, which are all the big teams that play. I'm going to go through very quickly the names of those. These are ones that you can use to inspire you, or you can come up with your own. So we have the Arizona Cardinals. We have the Atlanta Falcons. I like this one because it's not only is it a falcon, which is a bird of prey, but actually it makes the F shape for falcons with its silhouette, which is quite clever. We've got the Baltimore Ravens. They've also done a similar thing where they've got the B for Baltimore in the feathers of the Raven, which is very cool. We've got the Buffalo Bills. We've got the Carolina Panthers. We've got the Chicago Bears, which is one of the classic ones, but I actually think could be one that you could redesign because there's no bear on there. It's just a C for Chicago. We've got the Cincinnati Bengals. The Bengals, of course, being a type of tiger, so that's where they've got their inspiration. I quite like the tiger stripes on there. But the Cleveland Browns, they've got a kind of brown strip going across their helmet. We've got the Dallas Cowboys wearing that kind of sheriff badge, which is quite cool. The Denver Broncos, a bronco is a type of wild horse. We've got an obvious one here, the Detroit Lions. The next one is the Green Bay Packers. I think this might be Miss Chambers' team, but even if it's not year three, I know that one thing is that their name is representative of the fact that the people there actually were really good at packing ships years ago. So they haven't got quite as interesting a name as some of the other ones, but they've got a lot of history and it means a lot. So that's quite a cool logo because it represents the place and the team name represents the place as well. We've got the Houston Texans. We've got this is a rather nice ball there. We've got one of my kind of favorite teams, which is the Indianapolis Colts. They've got a horseshoe on here to represent that the colt is like a young horse. I think this one's really popular now. This team's called the Jacksonville Jaguars. They've definitely got one of the coolest logos. The Kansas City Chiefs, one of the best teams at the moment. We've got the Las Vegas Raiders, who've got this funky kind of man with an eye patch and a helmet and some swords in the background. We've got the Los Angeles Chargers, electricity bolt to represent the charge. We've got the LA Rams, new logo where they've incorporated the fact that a ram has a horn into the A, which I think is quite clever. You could do something similar with one of the other teams. Another team I absolutely love, probably my favourite team, the Miami Dolphins, pretty obvious here. Another logo I really like, this is the Minnesota Vikings. Got a Viking on. We've got the New England Patriots. We've got the New Orleans Saints. We've got the New York Giants. Now, they've got the N and the Y for New York. I don't necessarily think there's much about a giant on this. That one could be one that you could redesign if you'd like to. Another one that I think could be redesigned, the New York Jets. They've not actually got a jet plane on there. I think they've missed a trick there, because that could be really cool if you could have a jet plane on the side of the helmet. The only thing about this, some of these teams like New York teams, they're quite old, so the logo's very old, so they're not quite as jazzy as some of the newer logos that have incorporated more things. I think the Philadelphia Eagles is pretty obvious. Pittsburgh Steelers doesn't have an interesting name necessarily when you think about it, but it's actually another place where they famously made steel. Maybe you could incorporate something that's famously made out of steel into a new logo for them. San Francisco 49ers, because the 49 is the year that was important to that city. The Seattle Seahawks. We've got the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Buccaneers a bit like a pirate, so they've obviously got a pirate flag. Very cool there. Tennessee Titans. Titans are like giants. So huge, powerful things. And finally, Washington, who are in the process of renaming their teams. So you could actually come up with a brand new one for Washington, which would be very cool. So lots of different ideas there. They are on the sheet as well, so don't worry about trying to remember all this. You can, of course, go back and re-watch it if you want to have a particular picture. And if you have access to a tablet or a computer, you can have a little look to get some ideas for yourself. Now, you should all have one of these sheets. It's got the detail at the top, and at the bottom, it's got some examples of the teams. Now, it could be that you could look at something that you already like the look of, or if you actually have a team that you like, you can use those to inspire you. So, for example, I'm going to use two people in my class who I've got some ideas about what they might do. They might prove me wrong, but I'm going to give you some examples for them. So I know that, for example, in my class, Riley loves Seattle Seahawks. So he might decide to have a go at designing a new logo here. And rather than just picking the face of the hawk, he might put face and the wings. So it's kind of the whole silhouette on here. And he might decide that although he loves the colors, the green, the blue, he might try and change the sort of stripes that are going across to different colors that he likes, or color in the metal grill that protects your face in a different color. That's something that he could do as a fan of a team that's on that list. So it could be that, as I said, I'm not going to do the whole design for him. He might do the Seahawk and then the whole body across it. I'm not going to finish the design for him. Could do the design there and then choose, let's say, different colours that he likes. Obviously, green and blue would be traditional ones, but he might also like a bit of gold in there because they have won the Super Bowl before. So he might decide to do the rest of this bit green and blue, the traditional colours of that team. He might decide to start colouring in this gold colour. Perfect idea. Something along those lines for those of you who like an NFL team already, or think you could redesign or do a better job of one of the logos that are there. I think Washington's a really good one because they've got a new logo coming and nobody knows what it's going to be. So worth looking out for that one. You could come up with your own. The second option, I'm picking somebody who I know really likes something that definitely is in the team. I'm going to pick Emily, who's also in my class. I know she loves rainbow colours and I think she likes unicorns. So she might decide to come up with a completely new team. Let's say, for example, I know that they've considered making a team here in this country, like for London. She might decide, you know, Monkston. We're going to have the Monkston unicorns. So Emily might decide to draw her unicorn on here. There's a unicorn. Obviously, she can colour it in and make it more detailed. And then she can get all the different colours she likes and maybe do different stripes along. So green. Obviously, whoever is doing this is going to make sure that their colour is going to look better than mine, because I'm using an interactive whiteboard to give you ideas. I'm not doing the task for you. Lots of different colors that could be added to that. You can do the grill a different color. You can do the little strappings different colors. You could even have different colors on here. You can adjust what's on here. You don't have to just have one color around here. Now, I would recommend that that you try and make your design not too complicated, because it can be hard to get everything on there. The other thing that I'd expect year five and year six to try and do is try and make sure there's a bit of kind of angled perspective. So think about the angle of this when you're drawing it on there. It shouldn't just be directly flat against the side. It should almost look as though it's 3D slightly. Bit of a challenge for you five, six, but I know you can do it. Got some great artists across the school. Final thing. There is a prize, one prize, though, one mystery prize for the best design across the school. So teachers will be sending me the ones that they think are the best from their year groups. And myself and Miss Haller will decide on which is the best one from across the school. Now, I know some of you might have already watched the video for the PE Active Challenge. You think, hang on, there's quite a few prizes for that one, Mr. Craggs, but there's only one for the art. This is a PE challenge. So overall, we've got more prizes going on for the active challenge, but there could still be a prize for those artists amongst you. Now, the other thing that you can, of course, do is everyone's got the sheet. Everyone can do that. No one can miss out on that one. But if you know you've got time, you know you like doing crafts and you like making things, you could potentially go one better and you could make your own helmet. So what you would need is to make papier-mâché, which is the best way to do it. You would have a cup of flour, you'd have a cup of water, you mix together in a big bowl. I'd also recommend that you put lots of salt in there, probably a couple of teaspoons, just because those products, well, particularly the flour, is a type of food. If you left it for a long time, it could smell a bit. Whereas if you put the salt in, it'll be absolutely fine. You'll also need a balloon. What you would do is, blow up your balloon, obviously to a decent sort of head-like size, put the strips of paper into the papier-mâché that you've mixed up in the bowl. As you can see from the picture there, we've got somebody putting those onto their balloon. Once you've covered pretty much all of the balloon, you put it somewhere to dry for, I would say, at least a day, probably longer. And then what you can do is you can let down the balloon. Very funny. You've got what's left is the shape of almost a helmet. All you need to do is get a pair of scissors, cut out the section that you need, and then you can decorate it in any way you want. That's also another option. You don't have to do that and don't think, oh, I have to do that in order to win. No, this is about creativity. Everybody gets an opportunity to try something a bit different. So you can use an existing team and redesign it. You can come up with a brand new team. You can even, if you have the time and you have a parent who wants to give you that time to help you and knows that they've got all the things at home, please don't fuss with grown-ups saying, oh, I really, really want to make a helmet. If you have the time, you can do it. If you don't have the time, don't think, oh, I'm going to miss out. I'm going to miss out, Mr. Cranks. You're not going to miss out. You've got your sheet. It's about showing me what is in here on the page, because that's going to make it so that we can decide a winner. I'm looking forward to seeing some of these. Good luck with it. I think the key thing to do is, regardless of whether or not you're coming up with a new team or if you're redesigning an old one, is take some time over it. Don't rush straight in, because the more time you put into it, the better it will look. I look forward to seeing them.